A very good morning to all of you. I am here today to talk to you about concept of learning and teaching. In this session, we will going to discuss what is learning, discuss the principles of learning, understand the domains of learning, know what is teaching, understand the function and principles of teaching, and finally believe we can do it. So let's start the concept of learning with this famous Chinese proverb. Tell me, I forget. Show me, I remember. Involve me, I understand. So learning is a systematic, relatively permanent change in the behavior that occurs through experiences. Implies that learning can only happen through the individual activity or his own doing. Learning can be intentional or unintentional. The main three ways of learning in classroom are visual, auditory, and kinesthetic. That means seeing, hearing, and doing. These pie charts represent you the percentage of learning through different five senses of our body. It shows that most important organ of sense is eyes. We perceive up to 80% of all impression by means of our sight. So subject matter should be primarily visual. If it is presented auditory, it is not so much beneficial, as learner perceive only 11% through the sense of hearing, while 3.5% through sense of touch, and only 1.5% through sense of smell and taste. Learners retain 10% of what they read, 20% of what they hear, 30% of what they see, 50% of what they see and hear, 70% of what they say as they talk, and 90% of what they say as they do a thing. So instead, talk to the students who sit in the class or listen the lecture passively. Demonstration, diagram, role play, films, these are the more effective ways to enhance the students' retention of what they are learning. There are some principles which may provide good guidance for effective learning. These are: the first principle of learning is the self-activity. Learning is an active process on the part of the learner. The kind of the learning which takes place is the result of the kind of the experience one has. Like conducting demonstration by the farmer in their own field provides opportunity of self-activity. That means learning by doing. This makes learning become effective and permanent. The second principle of learning is association. New learning may be associated with previous successful and satisfying responses. Like if the farmer have obtained profitable return by the application of nitrogenous fertilizers, they become motivated and ready to use these fertilizers in their crop production. The next principle is the transfer. Principle of transfer. Application of perceived relationships to another situation which is applicable. Unless knowledge of learning can be applied in a new situation, it very much restricted. Like if the farmer have learned the technique of the water management in the particular crop, the farmer know that how to use the water management in the some other crops too. The next principle is disassociation. Along with the association principle, for effective learning, undesirable responses are to be eliminated. This may be done by setting up a desirable situation which are more satisfying. Like when planting a crop line gives the better yield of the farmer, they may be advised not to practice broadcasting. The next principle is the principle of readiness. Learning takes place more effective when the learners are ready to learn. When farmers are ready to cooperate with good guidance, their learning becomes permanent and effective. The next principle is the principle of set or attitude. An unfavorable attitudes retard learning, while favorable attitude accelerate it. Unless attitude become favorable, adoption will not take place. Like when farmer develop a favorable attitudes toward the good water management practices, then they can be use the water management practices in their field. The next principle is the principle of practice. Perfection is seldom achieved without practice. The practice must be correct, must be specific. The attainment of the preferences and the practices depend on the experiences. Like learning to use a sprayer correctly require practices several times over. The next principle of the motivation. Motivation means stimulation toward the action. When the farmer becomes motivated to learn, or learner becomes motivated to learn new things, then the learning becomes effective. Like favorable experience of planting trees motivate the tribal farmer to collect the sapling from the forest nursery. The next principle is of timing. Other things being equal, learning takes place more readily when there is an introduction of a topic or skills at a time. That means, when insects have appeared or are likely to appear in the crops, farmers shall ready to use the plant protection measure. The next principle of clarity of objective. The objective of the learning should be clear. By the objective of the learning, learner should know what they are going to learn. Like when farmer use the crop loan for growing the crops, they must be clear about the objective of getting the loan, how to use the loan, how to repayment of the loan, then they can use the loan effectively in their crop protection. The last principle of learning is satisfyingness. A satisfying after effect reinforces learning. When crop grown during the rabi and the summer season give the higher economic return and higher level of the satisfaction of the farmer. Farmer learn to invest more and take more care if they are satisfied with their crop production. Apart from all these principles, the Dale's cone of the experience is also modified that provide a linkage between the learning activity and participants' involvement. Now the question is, what is Dale's cone of experience? The cone of experience is a pictorial device used to explain the interrelationships of the various types of the audiovisual media as well as their individual position in the learning process. The one utmost principle of the cone of experience that it is based on the relationship of the various educational experience to reality, real life, and the bottom level of the cone, there is direct purposeful experiences which represent reality or the closest things to real everyday life. The opportunity for a learner to use a variety or several senses like sight, smell, tasting, hearing is considered in the cone. There are three levels of the cone of experience. The first is anective, which is a direct experiences. It includes direct and purposeful experiences where the learners learn the things by doing the real things actively, like working for a shelter, working for the poor people, welfare of the rural women. Then contrived experience, that means representation of the reality through mock-up and the model. And the third one is the dramatized experiences, that includes a role play in which the learners are actively involved in the activity. The second level of the cone of experience is iconic, that is include the pictorial experiences, demonstration, field trips, exhibits, education and television, motion pictures, recording, radio, still pictures, all are the way for the pictorial experiences. And the third one is the symbolic, highly abstract experiences, that is include visual and verbal symbols. Visual symbols includes charts, poster, and verbal symbol is related to the speaking and writing. As you can see, at the top level of the cone, learner perceive or receiving information verbally and visually. So their nature of involvement is passive, While at the bottom level, they become active learner because they are not only receiving the information but participating and learn by doing. Take a look about the domains of the learning. Humans are lifelong learners. From birth onward, we learn and assimilate what we have just learned into what we already know. The famous education psychologist Benjamin Bloom divided domains of the learning in three separate sections. The first is the cognitive, which is related to the knowledge and intellectual ability of the learner. The second one is the experiential, which is related to the skills of the learner. And the third one is the affective domain of the learning, which is related to the attitude of the learner. Sometimes these three domains of learning are also referred to as KSA, that means knowledge, skills and attitude. Let's discuss one by one. The first is the cognitive domains of the learning. It is also called the Bloom's taxonomy. This domain includes content knowledge and the development of the intellectual skills. This includes recall or recognition of the specific fact and concept that serve developing intellectual abilities and the skills. There are six levels of the revised Bloom taxonomy, and these are remember, understand, apply, analyze, evaluate, and create. So let's discuss the six levels one by one. The first is remembering. Knowledge here is defined as a remembering. In the simple words, you can see I know. Remembering means when you recall the previous learned information from your long-term memory. You wrote your learning or memorization. It involves recognizing or remembering fact, basic concept or answers without necessarily understanding of what they are or without knowing the details of a particular object. Like for example, give the name of three common varieties of apple or recite a policy or recite the some safety rules. The second level is understanding. Understanding the simple means comprehension. Comprehension means ability to understand the things in your own word. Translation, interpolation or interpretation of instructions and the problems in your own words is called understanding. When you construct meaning and capable to explain is. Like for example, compare the identifying characteristics of the two different varieties of apple, or rewrite the principle of test writing, or explain in your own words of the complex task of a particular steps, or explain the steps of a complex task. The third one is the applying. Applying means you can use it. Solving problem in new situation by applying acquired knowledge, fact, techniques and rules. Learners should be able to use their prior knowledge to solve their problems, identify the connection and the relationships, and they know must they how they apply their learning in the new situation. Like when you are capable to learn the varieties of the apple, when you are capable to compare the two varieties of apple, then would you know how to apple prevent scurvy? Scurvy, it means a disease caused by a deficiency of vitamin C. So this is a one example of applying. The another example is like use your manual to calculate an employment's vacation, or apply some law of statistics to evaluate the reliability of a written test. The fourth one is analyzing. The simple meaning of analyzing is I can be logical. Everything, whatever you do, there is some logic behind. Analyzing involves examine and breaking information into the component parts, determining how the parts are related to one another, there is some motive or cause. You are capable to making inferences and finding and evidences to support the generalization. For example, list the four ways of serving food made with the apple and explain which one is the more nutritious or which one have the highest health benefit. Provide the reference to support your statement. And the next one is evaluating. the simple means of evaluating when you judge something, that is called the evaluation. Making judgment based on a set of guidelines and the value of ideas or material. When you judge something, criticize and assess the information, that means you know the information, how it can be useful for you. What you know to make the decision and support your voice, your views. For example, which kind of apples are the best for taking a pie and why it is best. When you are capable to give the answer, that means you evaluate a particular practice. And the last one is the creating, which is a more abstract. That means now I am ready to plan. Now I am ready to do. Now I am ready to create something new by using my previous information. So builds a structure or a pattern from diverse elements. Put parts together to form a whole with emphasis on creating something new. For example, prepare some healthy recipes of apple pie by using your common ingredients. Whatever the ingredients which is devised by you for making the apple pie, and explain the health benefits of the others, ki how your apple pie is better than previous one. Or write some company operation, design some machine to perform tasks. So this is all about the Bloom's taxonomy. The second domain of the learning after cognitive is the experiential learning. Experiential domain of the learning is related to the skills of the learner. There are many methods and the ways by which you can improve the skills of the learner, like demonstration, real life experiences, simulations, models, mock-ups. All the activities and the methods where the learners are involved in the activity that just develop their skills. And then third domain of the learning is the affective learning. Affective learning focus on development of empathy, understanding, emotional connection with the topics or concept. In the simple words, it changes the unfavorable attitude of the learners or develops some favorable attitudes toward some practices or the skills. Some of the best ways to do this is through other experiences that can be found in the literature, poetry, art, guest speakers that are willing to share their experiences. So this is all about the learning. So let me now move on to the second next topic, that is teaching. You cannot give what you don't have. So teaching is an important part of the process of education along with learning. Its special function is to impart knowledge, develop understanding and